Good morning. The equation for the force of friction is... The force of friction equals the coefficient of friction times the force normal. And today we're going to make sure that you understand what the coefficient of friction is.
Flippin' physics!
The symbol for the coefficient of friction is the lowercase Greek letter mu. The word mu is spelled M-U, and the symbol looks like a U with a tail at the front. Let's solve for the units for the coefficient of friction. When we divide both sides by the force normal, we end up with the equation, the coefficient of friction equals the force of friction divided by the force normal. Bo, what then are the dimensions for the coefficient of friction?
Well, newtons are the dimensions for both the force of friction and the force normal. Therefore, the units for the coefficient of friction are newtons divided by newtons. But then the newtons cancel out, which leaves us with no dimensions. Is the coefficient of friction dimensionless?
Yes. Mu, the coefficient of friction, is our first dimensionless variable. It has no units. It represents the ratio of the force of friction divided by the force normal for any two given surfaces, and therefore has no dimensions. Now, the coefficient of friction depends on the materials of the two surfaces which are interacting to cause the force of friction. There are many published values for coefficients of friction. Here is one table from engineershandbook.com. Now, there are too many numbers here to discuss in this lecture, so let's reduce this table down to a few values and look more closely at those. You can see if aluminum is in contact with mild steel, the coefficient of static friction is 0.61, and the coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.47. If glass is in contact with nickel, the coefficient of static friction is 0.78, and the coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.56. You can find all sorts of tables for coefficients of friction between different materials. However, it is very important to understand the statement made at the top of the table I found at engineershandbook.com. Extreme care is needed in using friction coefficients, and additional independent references should be used. For any specific application, the ideal method of determining the coefficient of friction is by trials. In other words, coefficients of friction depend on the two specific surfaces which are contacting one another, and you should perform experiments to determine the coefficients of friction instead of relying on published values. There is no theoretical way to determine coefficients of friction. You must perform experiments. Billy, could you please take a look at the reduced table of coefficients of friction and tell me what you see about the relationship between the static and kinetic coefficients of friction for any set of two interacting materials?
Well, for aluminum on mild steel, the static coefficient of friction is greater than the kinetic. And for glass on glass, the coefficient of static friction is greater than the coefficient of kinetic friction. It looks like that's true for all of the materials on this data table. For any two contacting surfaces, the static coefficient of friction is greater than the kinetic coefficient of friction, right?
Billy, you are correct. Have you ever noticed it is harder to start something moving than it is to keep it in motion?
Sure.
Yeah.
That is because for any two interacting surfaces, the coefficient of static friction is greater than the coefficient of kinetic friction. Therefore, the maximum force of static friction is greater than the force of kinetic friction. Therefore, it is harder to start something moving than it is to keep it moving. Bobby, what would the coefficient of friction be if something were frictionless?
If there were no friction, wouldn't the coefficient of friction be zero?
Yes. A frictionless interaction would have a coefficient of friction of zero. That would give us zero as a lowest possible number for the coefficient of friction. In other words, the coefficient of friction could never be less than zero. As far as an upper range, the highest published value I have seen is a value of 4, and that was for drag racing tires on dry concrete. Admittedly, drag racing is a bit of an extreme of a situation. Therefore, under normal circumstances, I would say a maximum is perhaps 2. So if you're solving a problem and it's under normal circumstances, you get something outside that range from 0 to 2, then I would say you need to re-examine your solution. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.